What does it say before a marriage?
Do you have any objections to this marriage or something?
Hold your peace.
Yeah.
Hold my cock. Yeah! What episode is it?
I don't know.
Well, you may check.
You did one by yourself the other week.
Yeah, I just needed to hop on that Will Smith.
Clearly.
Excuse me. Let's see how many likes that reel got. I was just on someone's desk there.
50. This is 50.
That reel got 246 views. Compared to the last one, they got 184. That's the Will Smith effect. Gonna move this mic up.
We're talking about something that's popular.
Yeah,
I think we should really turn this down.
Just you.
Do you know what they're saying?
No, is it bad?
No, it's Japanese. It's
Ribbon Wilson. Now that the dual cast is back.
Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
I love that.
Mercy, I'm about to bust.
I love that sound so much.
Have you colored a grid though?
You can, but like, so for example, the first row is just classic dual cast colours, and then these ones are just was playing about a bit. That's just in case. Okay. I got shafted with this haircut. Haven't I? Haven't I been shafted with this?
I didn't properly look at it until you pointed it out.
I walked in this morning.
This is brand new this morning.
A female did it. This morning, in the barbers.
I have no comment.
And, no, make your comments all you want. Because it's not fair. Wait.
The girls that do mine are nice. They're down.
Are they?
They don't mess it up, I guess.
I'm not livid. But when my car went, beep, I went.
What's the point?
10.50. Which is
10.50? Mine's cheaper than that.
Like. Is it?
Yeah.
Shut up, mate. Come on. What is it?
It's like £9 for Scoville. Oh. I felt the tooth chip there. I felt your tooth actually chip.
That was lovely. I'm not happy. Well, it's not the world's worst haircut. Shut up. But it's one of those things. I walked in.
It's not the worst haircut you've ever had.
Well, what's been worse?
Being the skating. You know,
I love a skating.
No, do you know the video where you walk in, Jammy James cooking on the door video specifically, and then I just zoomed in on the...
Nah, that was good.
Yeah, it's funny.
That's like, hilarious, wasn't it? That's really funny. I walked in. Another way they usually ask you, what do you want, love?
Did you just say, be my guest?
She didn't even give me an option. Ben's texting.
I hope he doesn't.
He said, can't get down. No worries.
We're doing it on everybody.
I was made not for not setting, for setting up on the microphone.
Yeah.
I want all four of us episode, just because I think you're always going to have some funny moments when there's four people talking. Not that there isn't funny moments in this video talking.
Yeah, no, don't do that. I think my mic needs turned down, honestly.
Down?
Yeah. Because I think I'm generally louder than you anyway.
Okay, well.
Not when you're screaming, like, but you know.
DJ Hicks in the corner. What do you call it? You!
It's a really obscure reference.
Cool FM, I think. What do you call it? DJ Hicks in the corner. That worldwide famous DJ.
You have to be from here to understand that. I mean, not that anyone's listening.
Excuse me, we've an audience in Peru.
Do we?
That's a lie. New Zealand, I think.
Does Anchor tell you, like, specifically?
We're about to find out. I'll tell you where we have an audience. We're not going to look at the recent episode plays. No, we are not. Scroll. Okay, so.
Why can't I see it?
Here! So we have 3% of our listeners come from the United States.
Texas?
Specifically Texas.
That's a big majority from Texas.
18% in California. Washington, they're living it up. 8%.
Biden's listening.
Virginia, not so much, with 3%. Let me see. Oops.
What one's the Americans? Maybe the Will Smith. Well, if you said so, you don't want to check the most recent episodes.
2% of our listeners are non-specified gender.
I mean, it's mainly male gender.
Cracker.
We have...
Oh, here we go.
What? Oh, have you got the the rotor for
it? They have shafted me. I will be.
Have they shafted me?
I'm gonna text her right now about that and say hi. I text the manager and said, I'm not working next Friday. I can't work next Friday, and she just put me on next Friday. I'll be texting.
That's actually I got fine. Like, glad.
We're off school next Friday, aren't we? Or Thursday still?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna ask Ryan to swap.
And he'll
do it.
Really?
So let me see where our UK listeners are from.
But it's funny enough, Northern Ireland.
Yeah, I'm looking to see England twice. It doesn't give us specifics, but England, they're loving it. Togo? Where's Togo, mate?
Where's the
island? Ivory Coast? I don't even know where that is.
Not enough data. Because
one person flicked on by accident and switched off.
Because Dorcast means something different.
Probably. Togo?
In Togo?
I will not Togo in there. Let me see. Australia? In Victoria, in Australia, we have a listener.
Shout out.
If she tries to swap with me.
You doing this? Why are you just doing this live?
Go nuts.
Most of the time you start the podcast and be like, oh, we've got stuff to talk about.
You need to do my show. I don't think I do. I do not think I do. I should be listening.
Would you rather do a Friday or Saturday?
Oh, Friday.
No, no, do Friday.
But I'm busy the Friday, or else I'd do the Friday. Do you know what I mean?
You've been put on, buddy. I think you have to work.
I'll not be showing up, buddy. I'll have a notice, buddy.
Easter rising.
We're going to. It's on its way.
After Easter.
I am going to.
Do a special guest around.
Our special guest.
I haven't been told who this is to be fair, but.
Because he asked me. He said, can you please.
Put him on the podcast?
Let's see if this is definitely him.
What do you mean? How do you not know if it's definitely
him? This is him. Is it ringing?
Yes, but session we're not able to.
That's gone to the headphones. Nice.
It only cost 500 quid.
It's all worth it.
What's it?
Hello.
Hello. You're live.
Hello. I'm alive on the podcast, huh?
Who's this, Aaron?
Oh my.
ECVM, how are you?
ECVM, dead fights. This is, I'm going to come here.
Is he doing his moving image?
You're
right
in St. Max right now, aren't you?
The deadline was yesterday.
How long have you been there for?
Since 8, boy. Since fucking 8.
It is 20 past 2 right now, for context. Oh my goodness.
I left yesterday at like 5:30.
Lad, how do you not just get the film done?
Because, do you know what it is, Aaron? I'm perfecting it.
Are you, buddy?
How do you perfect a dump on the sink, mate?
Nah, I think it's the power you say it.
How do you perfect a bomb site, mate? Do you know what I mean? Like,
you know?
Nah, like skirmish studios, they're going down.
Can you give me the synopsis of your film?
Should we not like break it down that Elliot is in school right now on our Easter break off editing this film,
doing your coursework for your moving image arts,
any of it, and the deadline was yesterday?
Well, deadline's when I say the deadline
is. is it
so give me the synopsis of your film there, by
it's this is, it's a masterpiece.
It's not what a synopsis is. The synopsis is give me a rough story of.
Here, you give me your rough story.
That's not what we asked for.
I've done it in the podcast before. I'll do it again, but I want to hear yours first.
Well, at least mine's not just reusing the same people.
Go and end this phone call because I'll do it. What is your synopsis? What is the plot of your film?
The whole point of your film is it's two same people. Like, it's not.
Yeah.
It's not a gimmick.
It's not like I didn't have the actors.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
Elliot, your film is just long shots. There is no break in it.
No, you can literally
see the lighting guy in one of the shots just moving.
That's edited out now. Like, but you know what it is? There's not one long shot in it now because it has to be a 1:20.
And how much footage do you have?
Like 18 minutes worth.
That's cutting. That's being generous.
So
will you have this finished by today?
Well, like, being realistic, you know, maybe.
No, maybe. Okay, I'm going to put 50 quid
And you're not.
And Gurley's a betting man now, so he'll back me.
That's a lot of money.
Christian, what on me finishing today?
Know that you will not finish it today.
I don't think you will. Like,
you will not.
No,
have,
easy bank.
You will not have handled that film in today.
Easy bank.
Or maybe the film, but like not all the coursework.
Or an ease and a hand, or no, not hands. Fucking good today.
I am, yeah.
Well, I'll pop in the center, and you better have the 50 quid waiting for me. Okay.
Well, you do that. Thanks very much for being a guest in the Dualcast.
Oh, here, it would be... What did you do about me?
Elliot, probably. Give us a really controversial and cancelling take from yourself.
Yes, yes, yes. Oh, here.
What's something that, like...
Give me your harshest... What is your least favourite religion, Elliot? Go.
What's something, like, people generally agree on, but you have the complete opposite view?
Right, do you know what it is? Do you know what, like, so it's like a hot take?
Yeah. Yeah. It's not really a hot take.
Okay, thank you very much for coming on to the Dualcast. Thank you very, very much. That was the. I can't believe he's just said that in the podcast. Okay, enjoy your film, mate. All right.
You could have said a lot more.
Thank you. Bye bye. That was. I cannot. There are people that listen to this that will not be happy with that statement, but sure. That is Elliot McKeown.
I really wanted him to say something like really.
Well, I wanted him to really. I wanted him to.
Cancel.
Have a go at a foreigner or something like that. No, because that's bad. Wait.
Did you?
Out of this office right now. Out! That's my favourite. But I did a podcast. I that podcast did marginally well considering it's an audio only. Shut up, mate.
Did it?
What's the highest audio only? As you can see, they're really skyrocketing through the roof. That did pretty well.
Probably because it was...
That did pretty well. Nice. Oh, I'm still in it. Let me see. It's the same page. Some of these didn't... Ah, did
Shane
well.
Talbot, obviously. Saving your...
Saving me yet again. It's like four times he's done that.
Right.
Yeah, so that was Elliot McKeown. Here, the Netherlands.
Who's listening to that?
North. The entire country of North Brambert is...
No, it's not a city.
We'll see what it looks like, won't we? I can't copy this.
Just north population, actually. Because if there's like three people there, it's like... I don't think he spelled it right.
Yeah, well.
Population 2.545 million.
And the entirety is listening in the Dutch province of Rotterdam.
Nice.
Only 5,000 kilometers long.
Only?
2% of people are listening on Castbox.
Where, sorry?
Castbox.
No, I know I heard you, but...
And the other 8% are in the Matrix or something listening. Because I don't know. If you're either listening on Spotify or Apple, I don't know what other platform you're getting this on. Because YouTube's not connected to this, so I do not know where. And no one's listening on YouTube anyway. Come on, the boys. But yeah. There was Elliot McKeown.
What did he just ring you out of the blue then earlier?
I was in work yesterday on my break, and he rings me and he goes, "Come right here, bye." I went, "What?" And he was like, "I'm in the shop. Where are you, bye?" I went, "I'm on my break." Why? And he said, "I'm looking at this Danny here, bye, and there's a tomato, like a wee thin piece of paper, and I want it." And I went, "That's awesome." But I'm not. I am not.
He's an NPC.
I'm not moving a centimeter forward to get you it.
He doesn't exist, but
I got threatened at work the other week.
By who?
No, you were there.
Oh,
he
yeah.
He threatened me to your face, and he didn't back me up. He just went,
"No,
aye, Captain."
No. Out of context.
Do you know what Derwood said to me? He's like, I thought Aaron would have backed you up.
No, but I told you that I didn't know what he said. Like, I didn't get the gravity of the situation until after.
Aaron signed my will away.
Explain what you have been doing and what you were doing that night. So
for the past, like, couple of weeks.
2-3 weeks.
The past 2 weeks. Elliot's text me. Let's see what he says.
Cut that out, bye.
What would you do without me? Probably...
Succeed.
Have a decent podcast. Remember he was going to start his podcast?
Diesel. I think that would have been a good name for it.
Oh, I've been asked to do Saturday the 23rd for 30 quid. But am I the douche?
How badly does she want that off?
Just say, I'll do the next. Just text. That's a bit odd. I mean, 30 quid? Am I the douche for taking 30 quid, though, off someone?
I'd say cash in hand straight away.
Well, you might. And then don't show up for the shift. Yeah. Woo!
What do you have been doing? You can do a funny half hour towards the end of the night.
So for the past, it's come up to what? It's after 10.
It's like 9:30 it starts.
And
I'm talking in general, when this starts.
And
what do you do normally?
Me and Aaron a few weeks ago decided to see who did the better joke. We're laughing work, right? So Aaron gave his go and I gave mine. I'll show you what mine sounds like, and I'll actually turn my microphone down. I turned both microphones. Wait, can you hear that? Right, but imagine that on the roids, right?
It's in a shop,
really, really loudly. And I was doing this, you just do it when customers in the store, and then you hit the sprint out the back of the shop. So by the time they look around, you're gone, and they can't tell. Like,
I've had customers. So I've seen them laugh at it. I've seen them look around going, who's doing that? And we've seen the extremes of it. So normally you just walk about.
We've seen the assassination tent on Hoost's life that's left them scarred and deformed. What do you call it? Yeah, so I did it. All good, funny. Darren was wet himself. Then I did it again.
So you have a video of the specific laugh you did, which you can play. Right, the exact laugh he did here.
500 quid, you know.
What?
500 quid, and I can play that video thing with such ease.
Jerry?
The exact time that was 10:45. Jerry.
If you're in the shop, 10:45, like, what do you do?
So, like, 10:45, here, guy in last night, came in at 11. Wait. Was in for the full shop. Supervisor said, no.
No?
Went over to him and said, we're closed.
What did he say?
Hurry up. And to be fair, he just went to the till. Straight away.
What time is he
out? He was buying carrots.
Nah, mash, it's not all like
something like that. I was like, there's nothing unless you're going home to make a birthday cake out of carrots and mash or something, or like some
for
sort
Bugs
of
Bugs Bunny.
Yeah,
like.
Then what are you doing in the shop at 11 o'clock?
But what time is he out for?
What is it?
What time is he out?
2 minutes past.
Yep.
And you're like, the clock is a ticking, Buster. But anyway.
You do the laugh.
Do you want me to?
No, I
do the laugh, and I don't fully. I hit the sprint at the back, so yeah. I don't know what happens after this. Do you?
Well, I saw there was a guy and two girls, and I see that the girls are a bit confused, but the guy's angry looking, and he's looking about.
Sorry, does he have glasses?
I mean, I don't. He was actually so angry that he could have had purple afro hair, and I wouldn't have noticed. He was that fuming. I just would have noticed how angry he was and nothing else around him. But they sort of lingered for a bit after, like not buying anything, sort of like just sort of waiting about. And you go.
Because I said to you. And you go. So headsets didn't work. I said to you. Why are they still here?
And I just didn't.
I was like, are they still here? They're taking their time.
I didn't give an answer because I was just like, I'm not. I can't acknowledge because they'll be like, bring him out here. So, would you? I?
No.
So he comes over to me. Can I say exactly what he says, or do you want to?
Yeah, work away.
Are you need to bleep it or
no? No, don't worry. Well, I'll probably bleep the C word. Yeah, I don't imagine. Oh, well, no, he can't drop the C bomb on the podcast.
You demonetize Radlick, but so he comes over. He's just like, is there something wrong with him, there, mate? And he's buying like a salted caramel galaxy. Oh, that's so. The guy comes up and goes, he's buying like a salted caramel galaxy bar. That's all he has. He goes, something wrong with him there, mate. And I thought he was joking, like, oh, is there something wrong with him there?
Yeah, yeah.
And I was like, oh, there's plenty wrong with him, mate. And he goes, because I'll fucking knock him out. And I go, what? And he goes, he calls you a fat cow, yeah. We'll say. You know. Yeah,
didn't say cow.
Yeah. No, he did not. He said, yeah. He goes, the fat, whatever. Which, first off, I don't know how he saw, because he was just, it was the back of your head walking out. So even if he, there was no way he could have seen the flabs hanging out.
Appreciate that, man. Trying my best here. It's mad, like, I'm walking to work these days.
It's mad how he picked it up even just from the back.
Is it I?
Anyway, so, and I was like, what? And he goes, because he's got something to say, mate. He's got something to laugh about. Call him out and I'll speak to him myself. Mate, and you tell him I said that. And I just went, all right. And he walked off. And it was only about 2 minutes after I went, he was going to kill Daniel. So I did not throw you under the bus. I just went, right, okay, to sort of diffuse the situation. And
the negotiator here.
What
the
negotiator?
Do you know what you do?
Do you want me to be the negotiator or the referee, mate?
Do you know what you do? Like, do you what you say to him? Buddy? In this voice, buddy? We actually joke or laugh every Friday night. And
he's not going to believe
that. But you say, I promise you, he's not doing it to you. Here's a video I can show you of last week when he did it. And then the guy goes, oh, fair enough.
No, he doesn't. He goes,
walks out.
He just calls you a nut.
He's not doing it this week.
Yeah. Honestly, that's what I'm saying. Do you want to be the negotiator and get rid of, or the referee and say, ding, ding, in this corner and this corner, work away?
I'm not going to fight him.
No, he'd fight you. Like, it'd be a one-man boxer.
Wouldn't touch me, mate.
Would he not?
I nearly crashed the other day driving.
Oh, yeah, I wanted to ask you about that. But anyway, the guy comes and he sits in the car park and he, like, circles the car park for, like, 5-10 minutes after, and then just, like, goes 40 miles an hour up in the car park and leaves. And I was like, if you had came out, you would have died. So your driving lesson.
It's funny how Hoost survives another day. He's just built different.
Yeah, but built different, cowering in the back and stuff. Please don't let him in. Like,
what do you call it? So I drive him by the old instructor, T-Dog, during the week there. And we're doing roundabouts.
Is this your first time or second time?
This is my second time on the actual
road.
With him?
Or
third time with him. Second time on the actual, the big wide world. And he came to my house. He was in the passenger seat already. I was like, oh, flip, we're straight in this. Like, this is big dog.
I mean, you are the one that's learned to drive. Like.
Yeah, thank you. But for the past 2 lessons, he's driven me somewhere and then we've picked up from there. So he was like, you ready to go? I was like, yeah. Obviously, I haven't driven in a week since this.
You're forgetting hard to drive.
Just stalled right in front of my house. Oh, dude, I just stalled right in front of my house and I went, that's super.
You turned him, like, here's the lesson. Then,
got to the end of my, what do you call it?
Street.
Yeah. Or, like, where the Academy Club is, just at the end of the...
Well, you just started yourself.
I didn't kick on my house. North Bank, let's go. Whoa! I can't be saying that now.
I have no association.
Got to the end. This is you all over. Someone said this to me. Gurley doesn't want any of it. So, I can't remember who it was. It might have been Derwin said to me, Gurley doesn't want any of the smoke, yeah, ever. It's always used to say something and Gurley follows it with, I'm not me.
Because I'm not.
Not in the slightest me.
Because if you said something like, oh yeah, I want to attack this alt-right group, I'm going to be going, I do not want to have my stone.
Have you seen the video of Ezra Miller?
Choking a fan?
No, the
woman with the KKK, yeah.
The announcement he gave to the KKK.
It's like, you can just all kill yourself.
Hi, this is Ezra Miller, a.k.a. the Bengal Ghouls.
What
the
is
Mad Goose Wizard.
What?
And this is a message for the Beulahville chapter of the North Carolina Ku Klux Klan. Hello, first of all, how are y'all doing?
Like what?
You know, he's in the passenger seat, like, someone's driving.
Look,
just
if
listening.
Y'all want to die, I suggest just killing yourselves with your own gun. Okay? Otherwise...
He thinks he actually has the flash.
Keep doing exactly what you're doing right now, and you know what I'm talking about. And then, you know, we'll do it for you, if that's really what you want. Okay, talk to you soon, okay? Bye!
The guy is a nut. He is a Jared Leto of
job, like.
He is Jared Leto Jr., mate. He is. And Jared Leto's a freak of nature. I hate that guy. I
think genuinely he's a very talented actor. Have you seen Dallas Buyers Club?
No, but he something about him just doesn't
phenomenal on that, right? But I think everything else he's done. No, I haven't seen Requiem for a Dream, but I feel like everything else he's done has just been utter cack. Like,
I know it's utter cack. I can feel it.
I don't even. Yeah, don't even. What?
Lord have mercy! I'm about to burst.
What do you call it? But yeah, he is not. Did you see he was? They're gonna fire him. Did you see what came out recently?
Oh, he's arrested, wasn't he?
He's arrested, and he was causing issues on set. Let me see.
Of the Flash movie.
Yeah.
DC delays Ezra Miller's Flash prequel.
This here. Ezra Miller reportedly had frequent meltdowns on the set of The Flash.
I'm not gonna lie, that looks rubbish.
Really?
I think that looks absolutely rubbish. The lighting does not match whatsoever. His eyes and his face. Just, it literally just looks like they've got his face and the rest of it's CGI. I think that's what that is. I would bet that's what that is.
A report reveals that Ezra Miller had frequent meltdowns in the Flash movie set, though sources state they were not violent outbursts. Let me see. Behavior didn't result in any vocal or violence, but rather periods in which Miller was losing it. Ezra would get a thought in his head and say, "I don't know what I'm doing." No such emergency meeting took place. He's 29.
Let's scroll up that one. That picture. I think the helmet's too big.
It's too thick, I think.
Yeah, it's too thick compared to the rest of the suit. It looks heavy. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's hurting him.
Looks like your head's going to be way down after the body's wrong.
The Flash movie set, as a 29-year-old actor has been at the centre of controversy over the past few months following a cryptic Instagram video in which they call out the Ku Klux Klan and multiple incidents involving the police in Hawaii. They are reportedly arrested for harassing a couple at a karaoke bar. Miller also had a restraining order brought against them. This is The Flash, by the way.
Yeah.
As you want to die?
As much as...
I'll do it for you.
As much, yeah. Honestly, as much as the TV show has gone to, you know, the dogs... Grant Gustin, you wouldn't get him doing that. You wouldn't get Grant Gustin.
Sweetest
doing that.
Man on the world.
I love Grant Gustin.
I love him.
I haven't watched the show in about 7 years, but I
season
like
one
it.
Is top tier TV.
Season and one and two are good.
Season one itself is top tier TV. Okay. That's as good as it gets in my opinion. But sure,
Arrow season one's very good too.
But yes,
but they just should have stopped it after that.
At the end of my edge of my development,
you parking for your
and
driving.
I got up. And then, you know, I obviously stopped and put her into first because I was, no one was coming for that. And then a guy was letting me go and I went, okay, we're good. He stalled again right in front. And the instructor, he wasn't getting annoyed, but there was, "Oh, Daniel, I'm not trying to do it deliberately." But what do you call it? Yeah, so I stalled in front. Then got out. Was driving up to through Glengore up towards the High Town if you're going towards Edmund Rice.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And then was turning right or left, sorry, towards in the Glengormley and stopped at the lights of Glengormley. Then we're driving along past KFC direction Subway. And he just goes, "Just stop here."
Where, like in the middle of the road?
In the middle of the road. But there was these lines in the middle of the road, junky line. I don't know what they're called or what they do. But it obviously meant there was enough space with these junky lines in the middle between the two lanes where a car could get past. Fine. But in my head, I'm just going, well, I just can't stop in the middle of the road. I literally just can't do that. Because I think, well, if I just stop right now, I'll be like, what are you doing? So I just mount the curb. Well, not mount the curb. I looked for an opening. Where someone in the dips of people's driveways, and I sort of pulled into one of those, and
you're
he was like,
supposed to mount the car,
and he was like, "What the heck are you doing?" I'm sorry. I was like, he was like, "What are you doing?" I was like, "I'm trying to." He told me to stop, and he was like, "You don't do that." Now you have to reverse on the middle of the road, and I was like, "Get in the car yourself and do it." But in my mind, I was like, if I just stop in the middle of the road, bad idea. If he'd said to me, "It's all right, just stop in the middle of the road," here I would have.
I don't even know if it is.
Well, maybe it must be. It might be if you're
a learning driver, yeah. I think they'll give you away anything. But like
because that's what, in my mind, I was like, I cannot just stop in the middle of the road here. That's lunacy. So I thought, surely I can just.
Mm.
But no. Then went up towards Tesco's, near your neck of the woods, past the entryway to your gaff.
Thanks for not being specific.
Yeah, you're right. He went, what are you waving at? And I went,
yeah. Oh, wasn't it? When was this, a few days ago?
Tuesday night.
Wasn't even there.
Yeah. How was your hard labour?
Funny story about that. Not Why? Funny, it's just depressing. Why? Just always happens to me, like, doesn't it? Your brother was there?
Yes.
Where was Daniel Houston?
Daniel Houston got the dates wrong, okay?
Did he, buddy?
Daniel Houston thought he was in Port Rush.
Daniel Houston could have been making shit.
Monday, Tuesday. Here, I'm being overpaid by work anyway, it doesn't matter. Yeah! Well, I don't know what it is.
You better hope I not say that.
I don't care. I will leave tomorrow if I so desire.
So me and Ben, shout out to Ben, we were doing a bit of manual labour for my brother's mate's dad in Moira,
mm-hmm.
at Lisa Garden Centre. We were doing a bit of work for him. We're clearing out these greenhouses all day. Like, it was two 9-hour days. We had an hour break.
Did you not do it on Wednesday?
No.
Oh.
We had an hour break yesterday. Glug, glug, just. And basically, money has been a bit tight recently.
You all right?
No. It's a lot of it is from what the purchases I make. Like, I make a bat Lego Star Wars, doing whatever. Stuff that I have to buy. Like, I had to renew my passport, 75 quid. What? Because mine expired in 2018. It was a child's passport, so now I was an adult passport. Thanks. It's an adult passport now. I didn't get that sent off, so I hopefully it comes in time for the holiday. Like, I've got the holiday to pay, and I was thinking the money I get from this, cash in hand, lovely, will just either go straight towards a holiday or something else. Childish announced their new stuff. I'll be getting the hoodie, right?
I really want the sweats. I really, really, really want the sweats.
I might see. I want the hoodie, the sweats, and the coat and the socks, but that's gonna be about 300 quid, and I'm gonna go, oh my, I don't want to go to Spain or have some clothes. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's what it's gonna be. The pre-sale's tomorrow, actually.
Is it actually?
Yeah.
I'll be waiting.
Well, I'll be at work, but I'll find time to get it. Yeah, so anyway, at the end of these two, we have an hour-long break, and we have like two half-hour breaks, right? So, but we are doing a lot of work, like, but we didn't take before and after pictures, we should have. Time these greenhouses were clear, but you would have thought, oh my goodness, you're going to eat off the floors.
Yeah.
You shouldn't, but you get it off the floors of the entity. We're pulling trees out of them and stuff, plants, and we're, you know, raking whatever. I got the hoe out and all that and whatever.
It's a funny word for Ben Davidson. Sorry.
Yeah, I was waiting for a joke, but and at the end of it, I will disclose the amount that I got because I don't have it anymore. Right?
What?
Right. No. It happens to me. Right.
Did you get mugged?
No.
Could you imagine?
No.
It always happens to me. No.
So, but at the end of the days, I get 115 quid.
Mm.
And I go, very good, right? It's 115 quid I wouldn't have had beforehand. Money I do have now. Okie doke. And then I check and I have a voicemail. We have your daughter. And I'm going, oh, no. So, I
know. Oh, man. About three things flashed my head there. Aaron's daughter? Who's filming him? How do they have her? And they want the 115 quid for
specifically,
her?
Yeah. No, I get a call from...
It always happens to me.
Hi.
There you go, lad.
Hi, this is your insurance. Last year in July, when you signed on with us, you insured your car for 5,001 miles. I don't know why we added an extra one. 5,001 miles. And they go, you've used 4,820 of them. And I go, how much would you recommend that I add? And they say, well, 1.5K would do, like, maybe, but 2,000 miles would probably be to do you now until July. And I go,
how much?
How much is that going to cost me, buddy? And they go, that's going to come down to the small sum of £135. And I go, what is it? Sorry. So basically, I worked for negative 20 quid there. And I just, I'd have to just start to cry about
it. Do you know what it is though? You would have gotten that phone call regardless. So were you not pleased? But I'm glad I just got 115. Yeah,
it would be better if it came out of this being fund, I wouldn't drive for the rest of the year, but yeah, so that's a bit of manual labour all for make sure I can drive legally.
You down in Houston did Monday and Tuesday?
Nothing.
Sweet nothing.
Yeah. Daniel, you could have been making money, like.
I know, but I wouldn't have wanted to anyway. I hate money. What do you call it? I woke up at time on Monday.
Later?
Yeah, well, later than I should have been. I was just strolling about the place, thought, this is lovely, you know. Did I do anything on Monday? No. I went out on Monday night, just when we drive, with a friend, I was going to say a boyfriend, a group of friends.
It's funny how it turned from one friend to a group of friends, though.
And then Tuesday, I just nipped into town for a wee Spoon Street.
So?
And Wednesday I worked.
Dun, 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 dun.
Nah, see, I'll not have that though, will I? I will not take that lightly. I will.
If you know, you know.
We will have issues. We will have serious issues. I am sick and tired of defending myself of this claim.
You don't want to publicly say it, like.
I'll show the audience at home what Aaron was whistling there.
No, they know. They know. You're going to copyright strike for this anyway.
I get copyright strike regardless. Advert.
Everyone knows the first couple of chords. Like.
Yeah, but I just want to make it known that these claims are being passed around about me, and I am not one bit pleased. This is the longest advert ever, and I am not one bit pleased about them. Enough is enough. Not good. Not funny. No, not funny. John,
the fact is, I know it's not true.
The world knows it's not true. It's not. You're gonna rile me up.
Oh, sorry.
Come on. You're gonna rile me up.
I want you to get out of this office right now. Out.
No wheel this week, by the way. Just because we couldn't actually get the
thing off.
It was used by someone else, and they obviously changed everything that was on it. But
nobody wants that Blu-ray, clearly.
Struggling to get it scrubbed. You know what we'll do right now? We'll order some...
Do you have Loop finished, by the way? I wanted to ask that. That's a complicated no.
I had to... So what I had to do is... Loop is my coursework. I had to shorten it down to 7 minutes 50 seconds, but I had to cut out the entire first part.
Why did you have to shorten it to 7:50?
Because they sent it to Suya. They wanted something.
Are you gonna make it your own cut?
Had to be as short as possible. The actual version I still need to finish, which is just literally copy and paste the bit I had with the new music.
You see the boys finally got posted there, so it did.
Did.
What's that about?
No, it was good. It was really good, mate. It was really funny,
right?
Yeah.
Out!
Good comedy. What do you call it? What am I looking for? Right! Imagine I flipped the table. Imagine I flipped the table.
That was a daredevil primal scream.
£5 for a bit of flipping spray, isn't that? Imagine I flipped the table.
Right.
What are you doing?
You're Kingpin when he's in the...
I have £2,000 worth of equipment here.
He's in the prison. He just bangs Matt Murdock off a table.
£5, I'm guessing, then.
Right. No. We're not going to ignore your subtotal. Why do you have a Batman and Robin costume in your subtotal? £40 and £27.
You just never know. Well, you know
what I mean? It's in your basket. What do you mean you just never? It's not on your wish list. You were ready to order that. Batman Robin costume and some whiteboard conditioner spray. Why do you?
Because we're gonna do that wee sketch thing of Batman and Robin in Belfast, and I just that.
I forgot, like, I wouldn't have been in it, like.
Yeah, Ben would have been Robin. Right. Okay. Ben will be Robin.
I will not show up that day. I'm letting you know.
Shush, mate. You'll be recording it.
Well, from 30 years.
No,
back,
it'll be green screen. You stupid monkey. I didn't mean it like that. I didn't.
You get out of this office right now. Out.
So there's the Batman one. The mask is good, I think.
Is it a half mask?
Half mask, but it's like, I like the half mask look.
Do you?
And then there would be Ben's.
You're gonna spend.
Well, that's my issue. It comes to 73. What we'll do is we'll just buy this now. Oh, 8:35. 3-pound delivery for a bit of whiteboard.
Watch it not work as well.
That is. Shit, watching this.
Is it going to come up?
Just come up my account. Okay, maybe not.
You gonna donate a bit to Ukraine there?
Am I going to donate to Ukraine? Watch me close the tab. You watching? Boom, tab closed. I was speaking to a guy from Ukraine.
From what? On what?
This is a social media platform. And
right, a non-specific social media platform.
The hub. And I'm joking.
No, I know you are because this didn't happen.
No, I was speaking to a guy on social media. Why do you not believe it? I was speaking to a guy on a social media platform and he was like, A-okay over here?
I probably in his bunker, like.
With the 10 minutes of Wi-Fi yet today.
And the 3 cans of beans he has left.
Right.
Like, what? Wait, what are you?
Good song, all things considered.
It's not true.
Yeah,
so.
It's been true.
Mate! But it's just not true, you know what I mean?
Okay. We are Amazon Music?
We are. Oh, we must be on Amazon Music. Yeah, it looks like we're on Amazon Music.
If you're listening on Amazon Music,
have ever known one person to have Amazon Music. And I have a feeling it could be them that's listening. We're also on Pocket Casts, Radio Public, and Stitcher.
Nobody's on that.
How about I stitch your face, bruh? Anchor got bought by Spotify, did you see that? Anchor by Spotify.
Do you reckon they're going to make it Spotify exclusive?
Do you reckon we could just forget it when we can change that payment from available in the US only to available in the UK as well, guys?
You just truly use a VPN.
Mummy. Light bulb.
Do your TikTok. It's like a TikTok clip. It's like a moment in film where a character realizes something.
Houston
like the Truman Show.
Just realizes he can use a VPN and get some cash. 27p episode. As a treasurer, can you look in that? I was thinking about that before. You are the treasurer of this company. So if you can look in that for me.
I am the treasurer of this company.
You deal with the money. Money thief. Nah. We might need to buy this one. We whiteboard spray, is it? £8, mate.
You're the one that listened. I'm the financial advisor, if anything.
Yeah. Well, as a financial advisor, I'd like you to advise on my next course of action is VPN-wise.
Do you have a VPN?
Do I have a VPN? What do I look like? Neo, mate? No.
No, we're not protected. This isn't an ad, like, but...
Here.
Get Proton VPNs free. Try it now.
We need to get a podcast sponsorship. Frank and honest, we need to get that going. It's going to come. I can feel it. Sorry, I'm going to say that line again because that was too funny for me. It's going to come.
Lord have mercy, I'm about to burst.
The Frank and honest.
I went, oh, do we need to retake it? Because the mic wasn't picked up
No.
And then he just, yeah.
The Frank and Honest sponsorship is going to come.
Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
Yeah. It is. What other day is my working next week? It better not be.
I'm glad this is just the
buddy, I'm just telling you, I'm not working on Friday. whether it means I take off my lanyard and hang it, hang up my cape, my headset, because I am not working that neck. Honestly.
I've got a topic if you didn't have anything else to talk about.
Yeah, go work away.
Got a tattoo.
Oh, why? Yeah. A girl over here got a tattoo. Yeah. Can I see it?
Yeah, I need to sneeze badly, like, but. I hate this.
I'm
not going to be able to sneeze now. And I'm just going to sit here and wait.
You see a Strange Things 4 trailer?
No.
It looks. Here, we'll watch it right now. Will it looks we? Unreal, mate. Where do you see this bad boy?
Oh, man, I don't sneeze anymore. I think it should have hit the deer.
Nah, this one knocked on, but I gotta say, I was pleased with this when I saw it.
Is she bald again?
It's flashback.
You've broken everything.
Sketchy.
They're like 27, though.
What?
The kids.
Oh, no.
Your suffering is almost.
Big Ben.
Big Ben Davidson, yeah. Sure, it's nearly in the 90s.
Close to it, probably, yeah. Yiddies, yep, maybe. I think it looks unbelievable.
I forgot he died.
Dear Billy.
Brilliant.
I don't know if you can.
She's Taylor Swift.
She is Taylor Swift. Not pleased about that, to be honest. They're slagging off my good mate Jake Gyllenhaal, but also.
Ever since we left, everything's been.
You've lost this room.
The goat! The actual goat, mate. I love him.
Was he not in a really rubbish Twitch film?
Spray?
Finn Wolfhard does not want to be there, mate. He does not want to be there.
It's impossible.
A lot of focus on her.
Yeah.
That song's good.
Is it by The Who?
No idea.
They used The Who last time.
Located you guys far from Hawkins because I thought you'd be safe.
I'm Winona Ryder. That's all she says. But
pretty fit.
I've for been like 50, so I'm just good. Coming.
I'm afraid your friends at Hawkins are very much.
You need to put this trailer up as well because, like, on the screen, you just have an audio. Oh, okay. It's rubbish, like.
Mate, stop being a gimp.
I don't have my powers. Why not? Stop using them. Do you know what I mean?
We can't win this.
Spider-Man 2 excuse. Oh, he's the dad in Whiplash.
Oh, yeah.
But literally the best film of all time, just.
Look how good this bit looks. It's getting funky. What do you see?
See you on the other side.
He looks so good.
On the other side.
I forgot she existed as well. Most of these people I forgot existed.
Someone needs a rewatch. I was put here the goat. Hellboy.
Maybe I can still help. Even if it's the last thing I do.
Is this the last season then?
Second last.
People say Hawkins is cursed. They're not way off.
That one looks unreal.
It's time. You have lost.
Gurley doesn't look too pleased. Is it a no from you?
I was watching Midnight today.
Good.
Third episode.
Real? You watched today?
Yeah. Didn't watch it yesterday. Didn't have time.
It's good.
And one thing I have constantly
said. Don't like the sound of this.
About Marvel films or TV shows, anything. When the character development's good, it's good. It's great, even. But see, when a boring, rubbishly choreographed fight scene happens, I go.
Are you talking about yesterday's episode?
I'm talking about yesterday's episode.
You're a half me for a laugh,
the
sir.
The guy starts licking the knife and he's like, what are you I just go on my phone and play Candy Crush, man. I'm not going to lie when that happens.
What fight was this?
When he's on the rooftop, he's like, you killed him? Guess I'm going to have to get it out of you then. It's like, I hate that.
What about the bit in the actual suit? That fight? Don't you hit me. Again, you wreck again, me.
The stuff of him.
You destroy
the
me.
The stuff of him being like, oh, Stephen, I'm the end of the suit now. So, you know, where he's like, because Stephen knows the Egyptian stuff. I like that. I like the whole dual personality. I think Oscar Isaac's acting is good. When the acting is good, I think it's great.
You wreck me, sir. You know that.
Same thing with WandaVision. Love the first. You agree with this too now. You agreed what? With this. What? The what? First seven episodes were great. And then when it turned into generic Marvel schlock at the end of it.
You wrecked me. The final episode, yeah. The episode before that.
The episode before, when it was like, we have to defend this town and all the slaves inside it, Wanda. Is that what you have to do as
that
well?
That was the final episode.
I don't even know.
The episode before that was the most character-driven episode. And I remember thinking, as I was watching this, Gurley will love this. Because this is, there wasn't much action.
What was the episode beforehand?
It was her going back to her past.
Oh.
And I thought, when I was watching,
do you know what that is? That's the episode of The Office where the guy comes in and goes, can you, you know
exactly
what I'm talking
about?
The guy comes in and goes, I need to do a little HR check here. Can you tell us? And Toby goes, well, there was a few times. And would they just show clips from previous episodes? Because they don't have anything to actually make up an episode this season.
They all previous episodes?
Yeah. Most of them, like 90% of them. I think there was one original clip, the rest of it stuff. Like, I'm pretty sure they showed the No God Please No clip again and all that. Like, it's like, that's, you didn't have an episode to write there. You just needed airtime and you just didn't have it. So then you went, I'll tell you what we'll do, lads. You know? I don't like stuff like that.
It was all new, though. It was all that episode was all new.
Some of the stuff was good.
Character development. You just wanted to see what was up with a Ralph Boner. He's not happy. I didn't like that.
I wanted to see John Krasinski, mate, like the rest of us. My scientist friend this week. I can't wait.
We need to get Doctor Strange booked.
Yeah. But you know what she was like? I can't wait for you guys to meet my scientist mate this week. It's a big actor that I've loved to work with. And to be fair, I never saw the Paul Bettany interview. I just read it. I read it on IGN. It was like, it's a big actor. I can't wait to work with it.
He's taking the mic.
See, if you actually listen to the end, it's so obvious it's him. Because he's like, it's an actor I've always wanted to work with. Really good. It's like, you're being sarcastic here.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I like him though.
I like Paul Bettany. Yeah. Got a tattoo.
Oh, yeah!
Okay, this probably didn't wrap it up. I call shots, just as basically what it is.
Is it?
What are you going for?
I don't know, I'm just getting back to like a... No.
Okay. So, yes, I pick up a non-specific person, and then we... Yeah. I don't know if...
Not
that. Yeah. And then, because they have tattoos before... And they got them done at this place, so I was like, let's be having it. So I walk in and just go, to be honest, I will say I probably wouldn't have got the tattoo if I wasn't.
Know this person?
Yeah. Or not this soon.
Yeah.
So I, because it was just, it's...
I can't believe you got done this soon. I just blinked and you're like, yeah, it's on my arm. I was like, what?
That's what I felt as well. Actually, before it was just like, oh, there it is.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's healing up now. It should be healed like fully in a week. But it's better than what it was a few days ago. It was flaky a few days ago, but it's the healing process. And I walk in and I just go, we're going to get this booked preferably for next Saturday. I go in on a Saturday going, next Saturday is when we're going to get this booked. And I have a week to build it up. I'm going to go in and we'll just get it done there. And I walk in. What's up?
No.
No, you were going to ask something?
No. What I'm going to ask will make sense because you might answer my exact question.
Okay. When I walk in, the receptionist woman goes, and I forgot they do like piercings and stuff there as well. And so they're like, all right, can I book an appointment? She goes, what for? And I go, a tattoo. What do you think I'm here for, love? And then I went, oh, they do piercings
as
well.
You gripped her up.
What do you actually think I'm here for? No. So it's like a tattoo. And she was like, okay, we don't have anything until the end of May. And this is April. And I go...
Somewhere else then?
I go, it'll be somewhere else or I'll just get it booked for then and we'll wait and get it done then. And as I'm saying that, the tattoo artist, the only one it is one of the tattoo artists is a few nipple piercers, but there's one tattoo artist. He comes down and he's done the tattoos before. I'm the non-specific person I know. And he was like, what's wrong? He's like, he's this wee boy, he's trying to get... I'm like, love,
That would wreck me. That would actually wreck me.
No, I don't think she said this to me, but I think I
some
just...
guy, I was serving some the other day and went, mucker. And I went, don't you dare call me mucker.
I think I know who exactly that is. Is there a mucker? Okay.
No, he said wee mucker to me.
Nah.
Wee mucker.
Nah. If I get called,
I'm going to spank you, sir. But, sorry.
I want you to get out of this office right now. Out!
You're going to do what?
Why?
Why does
that
go out? You're going to do what? Sorry.
Someone's going to isolate that clip.
Yeah, I hope so, because you've done that to yourself.
I'm not even repeating it. Sorry.
No. Jeepers. Sorry. And he comes down and goes, I don't think she said this week, but, you know, if she said this wee guy, I'd be like, what is it, sorry, love? Just because the platform's elevated you're standing on doesn't come around and knock you out.
You say this to her, you put your hand on her shoulder and just go, what's that, sorry, love? Just because your platform's elevated doesn't mean I'm not going to come around and knock you out. Tattoo, please, mate.
Yeah. He goes down and goes, what's wrong? And I go, I'm trying to book a tattoo here. And he goes, what are you getting? And I go, it's going to be a symbol about this way right here on my arm. And he goes, the context is about 20 past one. No, it's about 20 to 2. And he goes, this never happens.
You said this too?
Yeah. He says, this never, ever happens. I've just had a half one cancellation. And my next appointment's 3:30. I can get that done in about 40 minutes if you want to do it right now. And I just went, yep, we'll do it. Walked up and he said, like, this is walk-ins don't happen.
Yeah.
Especially now. Like
but before COVID time.
And well, not even that, just like in the age of modern technology.
Yeah.
Brother. He said, like, in the '80s, the 70s or 90s, you could probably, walk-ins were obviously all that, like, you just, that's what you did, or you'd bring me phone up, but like you would walk in, you still phone up now, but you just walk in, maybe get it done. But they're so uncommon, don't happen. And I go in and I show him, and I'll just spoil it. It's a Batman tattoo. It's a bat, not this bat symbol. Nice. This is the Batman Beyond symbol. It's also on my, it's my lanyard as well. I've been watching a couple, but I love Batman Beyond. It's really cool, proper cool. Bruce Wayne's like 94, and he's like, he's still. What are you doing?
No,
I thought you were gonna do the Virgin one. I was gonna be like,
no, sorry.
And then I would have got the Palpatine. Ironic. So we are getting the tattoo done. And it was going to be, for Christ of context, it's the Christopher Nolan's...
Christopher Nolan Batman symbol?
Christopher Nolan Batman symbol. And I was just going to get just the symbol, like just it. And I went, it's a bit plain. And then I looked up, I know the Dark Knight Rises one existed, but I was thinking, I don't know if I want coming out, maybe going in, like a few cracks in it.
Yeah.
As if like the Batarang had been chipped off somewhere, or like but a silver indentation somewhere, mate. And he was just like, I was like, sure. And he goes, oh, I could do that one, and it's the Dark Knight Rises. And I go, yeah, but I feel like we'd have to take away, like if you look up the Dark Knight Rises one, I know you know what it looks like, but I didn't get the exact one because there's a lot of cracks coming out of it. And I said, if you can print that off and sort of make your own, like I don't want to lose the shape essentially of it. Yeah, like that one.
Oh, like that one there?
Yeah.
That's
the one. I didn't want to lose the shape of it.
It's also, not that it sounds stupid, it almost looks like it hasn't been finished. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. So.
Whereas that.
I didn't want to lose the shape of it. So we, I say we all get a group tattoo sometime, like a wee small one. It's not expensive either.
Dole logo.
No.
Would you not get a wee Dole logo?
No, I would not.
A wee small Dole. If we ever hit a milestone.
A million.
Shush, mate. Would you not get like a wee, like...
No. Dole? No. On my foot, maybe. Nowhere else.
Oh, shush, lad. Mate, just... damage.
Jared Leto, yeah.
Like, I don't know. A wee microphone? You're not getting a wee microphone?
No. See, I was going to get a Whiplash one, but, like, the blood on the drums, but I don't play drums, so it would kind of be like...
Do you? Is that what it'd say? Sorry.
But I don't play drums, so it would have been like, what do you have a drum tattoo? It was about Whiplash, my favorite movie, but I don't play drums, so I thought, maybe a Back to the Future one in the future. Who knows?
A wee microphone? A wee roadcaster? Are we pod mic tattoo?
Would you?
Just...
You can get, like...
Shush, mate. You know what? Forget it.
Somebody asked me after I showed them it. They were like, oh, would you? I was talking about like, oh, I probably would only ever get like movie tattoos. And somebody was like, I don't know who it was with other parties. And they're like, oh, would you ever get like, and I'd never spoken to them, but they were like, would you ever get a movie, like tattoos of your own films? And I went, no. No.
My face.
Yeah, your face looking down at Ben. I'm like, what can you even do? The John Doe name tag.
John Doe name tag would be kind of good. Like, John Doe's name tag would be good. What else would be...
I can't think of anything in the job went wrong.
Yeah, I don't think you could do anything. Maybe the gun or something.
But it's like, that's just a gun, isn't it? That's what I'm thinking. Maybe a couple of key props next time. You get tattoos of them? No.
What could you do for a lip?
Wig. So, you probably just get, like, two silhouettes fighting each other. Like, really small. Do you like the jump?
Girly bat!
What's that? Did you hear that?
The mic was telling you to calm down.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, it was like a little whimper.
Was it a woman singing or something?
Or
a dog?
I have
a... Girly bashed my wig process. For a while. Is that not fair? When we put it on in that petrol station...
I had... Because I had to wear it.
And you went, mate... No. Does it look better?
It looks better.
Just Ryan wearing a wig.
Oh, yeah, well, no, obviously, yeah.
Yeah.
Was that one make any sense?
Exactly.
Anyway, so that camera's about to die, so I'm going to quickly switch the battery out. Yeah, so I got a Dark Knight. I will show you it eventually.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you've seen it, but it's hailing up now, so you saw one was a bit flaky.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
So everyone knows the Dark Knight Rises logo.
Yeah.
I mean, you'll see the tattoo.
I might stick it on the screen or something. Yeah, like well. Feeling like it.
No, you're not. You edit and just go, come on, B, come on, B, come on, B, come on, B, come on.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's the truth.
You're about to make a joke and went, no, that's just actually what I do. That don't blame me. So he, I just completely, so he has these, like, you know, when you think of tattoos, you think of like the needle and then like a big long wire of like ink going into this machine or whatever. He had them, but they were all hanging up, and he goes, see this bad boy? And he holds up like this little, like, imagine like you're like an electric razor.
Yeah,
like a straight up electric razor. And like, yeah, right enough, the electric razor, you have the head on it, you take the head off, underneath it's got like a little, what would the rotor that spin, imagine literally that but turned around as if it was a pen. And he's like, this bad boy makes everything so much easier. And I go, is that what you're gonna be using? He goes, yeah. Turns it on, you dip it in, he goes, ready. Actually, that's skipping ahead. What do you do beforehand is he prints it off, draws our, like, our own version of it, because it's not as flaky as that. It's a lot more, like, there's a lot more, like, spikes around the outside than as opposed to the inside, which I kind of like. It's my own sort of one, but obviously at the same time, not. It's based off the Dark Knight Rises. And he puts it on, like, blue ink. And he sticks it down, like, he sticks it here first, and I go, it's too far down. Yeah, I says, can you move it up to here? And he goes, yeah, no worries. Puts it on, and then the outline's on you. And he goes, you ready? And I go, yeah, no worries. And either way, right, if I was by myself, I could probably admit that it was sore. But because there's a non-specific person sitting in the corner, I'm going, I just got a hack, like, it's nuts.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
you considering can, they've got them before as well.
Yeah, yeah. You can take a guess where the non-specific person is, but anyway, you can't obviously, but the viewers can't. So it goes, ready? And it starts drawing the outline. The outline was actually the longest part, like, drawn out. Because I was like, whoa, it's kind of sore, buddy. How long is it going to take to do the fill yet? No, but it was because I was talking rubbish to him. Like, I was talking absolutely. He was telling me how he's on, like, beta blockers and stuff because he did steroids. And I was like, cheers. He was dead on. No, he's probably not. I'd love to go back to him. He was dead on, quick, got my done. It was fairly cheap as well.
Did you get anything to eat after?
Yeah, got a nice burger.
Did you?
Lovely burger.
Where from?
Have you ever been to the Wee Bistro?
No.
Lovely. I wish you go.
With the.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. It was nice.
Yeah,
we should go to Wee Bistro.
I had a cling film wrapped around me, and
we should go to Wee Bistro.
Not now, like, but sometime.
No, I'm working.
The chicken burger I had. Oh,
burger, well.
Send me away, mate.
Keep
enough.
Pricey side.
I'm
here's a real question. Does a side cost extra, or does it come with a meal?
I think it comes with a meal.
Ooh.
And I'm gonna say,
Wee,
like,
Bistro, are you treating me?
I'm gonna say, like, you'll probably spend about 12, 13 quid. That's all I'm saying.
That's not awful. It's not awful. Does that include a drink?
Probably.
Okay.
It'll be, look, I'm going to say
You know what? Water's free.
I'm going to say like max 15 quid is what you spend there. Okay. I think we should all go. It's very nice. This is a shout. The wee Beast want to sponsor us? Absolutely.
Hey, where's Beast?
Glengormley.
Right, Wee Bistro, let's get it sorted. If you have an Instagram, I will find it and I will send you this clip.
Like Liam Neeson.
The Dolecast. Here, Liam Neeson was in Derry Girls. Yeah. I'm on a TV show, Liam Neeson, is it I? Oh, yeah. I am.
That's like me saying I'm in a movie with Batman.
Hi.
I'm in the Wonder Children, but Ian Glenn.
Well, yeah, no,
he plays Bruce Wayne. Batman.
I would say, yep, you're in a movie with Batman. And I'm in a movie with Qui-Gon Jinn. And I'm in a movie with his name isn't Taken.
Liam Neeson and Taken, yeah.
Wee Bistro, sponsor the Dolecast. We will eat your food constantly. We will be there constantly. You will get to know us like one of your own. And we will promote it like anything else podcast.
You're not even asking for money.
I'm not asking for money. I am not even asking for free food. Maybe the odd wee chip thrown in there, but nothing else. So
it is
please,
it's a lovely wee place.
Please, like, Wee Bistro. I just want to see a sponsorship.
Do you know where the side door used to be? Side door's lovely as well.
I don't know where that is.
Side door's a classic Glengormley spot.
Where is it?
It's been moved now. It's up a road now.
Where
used
is
to be? Do you know?
In relation to McDonald's.
This is awful. Do you know where the? I was actually. I just couldn't think of another way to describe where it was. That's awful. Are you at work half for? That's good. Welcome back. Please cut that.
No, I flagged that one.
Yeah. So I'll describe it better. See if you're going to Glengormley. See if you come from my house.
Yeah.
You go around. There's two roundabouts. Tesco's is there.
Yeah.
You go straight on. Down to Glengormley Park's on the left-hand side. Literally up at street and to the left. Like the next left after you pass Glengormley Park. It's hidden away. It's so hidden away, but it's lovely.
Okay, well, we'll go for a wee beast.
When's everybody free, I'd say?
Mate, trying to get four people to do this podcast today.
You'll just go then, sure.
Well, no. I want others. Ryan and Ben going there. No, I want to. I'm not treating them. I want to. I want to bring
treat them to an invitation.
I want to bring us, Marty, Longsdale, Ryan, and Ben, the main figures in Dole. I want to bring them for a wee bistro.
Ben, Winston is my podcast start back in Lonsdale.
Ben, I'll be in the video podcast as soon as I started back in Lonsdale. I don't see you here. Anyway, not the way I offered them, but
anyway, so I'll finish off this tattoo story quick and around this. Again, I call shots just. So imagine, someone was like, what does it feel like? Everyone was like, what does it feel like? Did I tell you what it felt like? It felt like someone with like a really, really ragged nail. And this is what people describe it as, like, and just really went in. Like, right? Like that, right? Or how I like to describe it in terms of like putting people off it for life. It's so funny. I'm gonna go get another one. I'm getting the Mandalorian. I'm getting the Mandalorian from here to here. Big one, like from my birthday. Addicted. No, not even that. That'll be the last one for a while, maybe. I mean, my back's fairly empty, like. Back's
eel.
Have you seen Ben Affleck's tattoo?
No.
Look up Ben Affleck back tattoo. It's the worst thing I've ever seen. I love Ben Affleck, but it is the worst back tattoo. Sorry. Be ironic about that tattoo.
Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy. Right.
Oh.
Looking well there, Bruce.
Oh, pal.
Oh, now come on. No, that is brilliant.
That's not like.
You're feeling no one there, mate. It's shocking.
Not the best, like. Yeah, not great. That must have taken so long as well. That's your entire back. Look at Ben Affleck back tattoo if you haven't seen it. Anyway, how I like to describe it is, say you're going to get an injection and the nurse comes up to you and goes, Pfizer, love, in this arm? And they go, chikoo. And then they just go, draw a bat symbol with the needle in you.
As in, like, they don't take it out.
They don't take it out. They take it out every now and then. They, like, tap up the, and then they go again. Basically, like, a nurse is drawing a needle, like, drawing with a needle in your arm and then filling it in. It's not bad though. I describe it like that, and it's not bad.
Yeah, yeah.
It is the scratch description is like it's a very, very heavy scratch.
Okay, yeah, that's not bad.
It does like it does cause plasma and blood to come out. Like you saw that in the Kling film. Like someone was like, "Is that part of it?" And I was like, "No."
I asked you if the red was part of it.
Yeah. But I'll see if I can get it off here. No, I won't be able. Sure.
Has he? Has he done it?
Yeah.
That's
it.
Let's see.
That camera's actually probably better.
That's nice, bro.
It's still healing, actually. And it's more flaky because I've been moisturizing it.
Have you?
No, it's not as bad as Ben Affleck's. Like.
No, it's not.
Plus, you can hide it. Like, you would never know.
Yeah, yeah.
Unless I told you. Which you did.
Hey. Up top. Just you watch the mic there, buddy. So that is the Doorcast episode 53 of the Doorcast. We will probably not be back at the same time next week. I would love to be, folks. I really would love to be. But simply put, we just won't be because life gets in the way. But,
Ben. Tell you what doesn't get in the way of things,
Wee Bistro. I'll be vlogging that one. Belfast, buddy, getting about in Belfast. I'm sorry. Right, okay. Keep your eyes peeled for that one. Care about it. So, thank you very much, and we will see you later. Goodbye.